Hello! In the last video I showed you my super minimalistic Z80 computer with only three ICs. The Z80 itself, a battery buffered static RAM, and a serial I/O chip. An Arduino Mega writes the programs directly into memory and is only necessary for programming. The whole thing can be programmed in assembler. See my last video if you want to know more details. But a computer only becomes useful with an operating system. Okay, an 8-bit CPU with 4 MHz clock frequency and a 64 kilobyte of RAM will definitely not run Windows or Linux. But let us go on a journey through time back to the late 70s and early 80s when the Z80 processor just came to the market. 64 kilobyte was incredibly much at this time. Back in these days, CPM was the most widespread operating system for the first personal computers. CPM was launched in 1974 and was originally written for the Intel 8080. But as the Z80 command set includes all the 8080 commands as well, it could also run on Z80 processors. Later versions included also the Z80 commands and so could utilize the Z80 more efficiently. At the end of its life cycle, there were also versions for the Intel 16-bit processors 8086 and 8088 and Motorola 68000 available. Although CPM was ported to the 8086 and 8088, it was displaced by DOS in the mid of the 80s, but many concepts of CPM were taken over, for example the drive letters and the 8.3 name format of the file names. So you can consider CPM as the father of DOS and grandfather of Windows. And as CPM has become open source now, I decided to run CPM version 3 on my Z80 computer. So in this video I will show you how CPM works and also demonstrate some of the programs that were used back in these days. CPM consists mainly of three parts. The BDOS is the kernel of CPM. It provides the interface between the application programs and the physical components, like data terminals, disk drives, printers and so on. The BIOS performs all physical I/O in the system. It consists of various routines that must be adapted to the particular hardware by the manufacturer. Both BIOS and BDOS are compiled into a file named cpmsys and loaded to the top of the memory during boot. It takes approximately 10 kilobytes of RAM. Below is the transient program area, to where the user applications and their data are being loaded. The command console processor, or CCP, is the command line shell of CPM. It is used to perform basic file operations like viewing, copying, renaming and erasing files, starting programs or doing system maintenance. It gets loaded into the TPA on boot and whenever a user program has been terminated. All we have to do to boot CPM is loading the cpmsys file to its appropriate memory location and jump to the boot routine in the BIOS. The BIOS will then initialize the I/O devices, the system variables and buffers and load the CCP into the TPA. I wrote a little cute app that sends the kernel to the Arduino Mega over USB. The Arduino then writes it directly into memory by the pin header. After CPM has booted, my Z80 computer uses the second serial interface of the Dart chip for file I/O. The Arduino is the broker between the serial and my Qt app. This setup emulates two hard disk drives with 8 megabytes each. Okay, enough theory. Let us start this thing up now. There it is. It boots very fast. Manufacturers could implement their own boot messages in the BIOS and so did I. Like DOS, the prompt shows the current drive letter. And like in DOS, the dir command lists the file on that drive. Similarly, I can use the wildcard quotation mark and asterisk to list only those files that match the pattern. By typing the drive letter followed by a colon, I can change the active drive. Up to 16 different drives are supported. But unlike DOS, CPM does not support any subdirectories. But with CPM3, it is possible to store files under 16 different user numbers. For example, I have my files from Multiplan under user 1. So when I type user 1, my prompt changes so that it shows the user number 1 next to the drive letter. When I type dir, it lists all the files that belong to user 1, the Multiplan files in this case. Multiplan is a spreadsheet program from Microsoft that was renamed to Excel later. Let's see how programs are being installed under CPM. On the distribution disk, we always have a program named install.com or similar. Let's start that program and go through the installation menu. Here we must choose a terminal. Different manufacturers of terminals use different terminal control codes. So every program had to be configured for the particular terminal used. Selecting no or the wrong terminal here would result in a crappy display. For PuTTY, ANSI terminal is the right selection. That's number 24. And again some music. Due to the limited memory space, programmers used no configuration files, but patched the configuration directly into the executable. So writing these changes takes rather long. I can start Multiplan with MP now. The start takes approximately 25 seconds. That's because the BIOS must read every single byte from the serial interface and write it into a buffer of 128 bytes of size. After that, the BDOS copies the content of this buffer to the right destination in the transient program area and requests the BIOS to fill the next 128 byte buffer. So the whole program goes through the Z80 twice. And anyway, although the clock rate is 4 MHz, the Z80 needs at least 4 clock cycles for an instruction. Some instructions take up to 20 cycles, so the effective clock frequency is less than 1 MHz. But now Multiplan has loaded. We can navigate through the menu with the space and backspace key or just type the first letter of the command. When I choose alpha, I can enter alphanumerical characters. With value, I can enter numbers. Now fill the first column with the names of my imaginary employees, their earnings into the second, and a ranking into the third column. And we can now, for example, sort the values in any order or perform any kind of calculation on it. For that, we have to enter the formula with the range of cells on which we want to do the calculation, and after a short time, we get the result. Even crude bar graphs are possible. There was a format option for the cell that displays as many asterisks as the value of the number.
Jim, I'm sorry, you're fired. Get out of here.
Another popular program was Wordstar, a powerful word processor. After startup, it shows the current user files and above them some commands. Let us type n to create a new file. They call it non-document here. Then enter a file name and confirm to create a new file. And now we are ready to type something. Please support this channel and click the subscribe button. You can also enable notifications and you will never miss anything. Also, your support through Patreon is appreciated. Unlike Multiplan, Wordstar had no menu to navigate through. To perform an action, the user had to hold the control key down and press one of the keys shown above. Moving the cursor was also done this way. For writing own programs, a copy of MBASIC came with many computers. This language was easy to learn and also easy to use. And after a long office day, we can relax with some games. Yes, it was once possible to play computer games without any high-resolution graphics, but just ASCII characters. The only sound was the beep from the terminal. There were not so much games for CPM, maybe another reason why CPM did not survive. Here you see a game named Catchum, the ASCII version of Pac-Man. And here I play Ladder, an ancestor of Donkey Kong. Oops, he got me. I was never so good at these games, because I always preferred to program computers rather than playing with them. As there are ASCII control codes that allow to change the color, it was of course possible to write a more or less colorful game. The game Gorilla utilizes this technique. Here, two gorillas throw explosive bananas on each other. The players had to enter angle and velocity until the opponent was hit. The game was ported to CPM in 2015 by a guy named Splendorio, attributions to him. It can be downloaded from his GitHub page. Okay, that's all for now. Again, thanks for watching and see you next time.